Hey everybody, my name's Alf Nephilim, welcome back to Doom. We've got all but one secret, and I'm not entirely sure where we're gonna find it. I saw something. There's just something that I didn't see. There's something there. Never mind, I think I know what that's all about. So yeah, let's just carry on for the time being. Yeah. I actually want to go here, see what's behind this area. It's not shaded in, so there might be something that I missed. There might be something all the way back here that I missed. And I'm not supposed to even go back there, apparently. And I'm sorry, guys, but I'm making sure I don't freaking miss stuff. I want to get the secrets. Because secrets give me weapon points. Weapon points let me upgrade my weapon. And upgrading my weapon lets me kill things faster. Killing things faster. Lets me survive better. Completely reading that map wrong. So this was nothing. Yeah, this was nothing. This was a waste of everyone's time. Especially yours. You didn't come here to see this. You came here to see me die. I regret to inform you that I don't plan to intentionally grant you that pleasure. It might accidentally happen. I am prone to killing myself, as we all know. Don't do that. That's weird. You're weird. Don't be weird. What's up here? Or rather, I guess just what's over here. God damn it. God damn it. I'm not finding anything. I'm not finding anything at all. Okay, continuing on with the intent to make progress. This is where I need to go. Their way this way. All right, time for a fight. So not where I wanted. So where are the demons that want to gnaw my face off? Oh, here they are. And what are you, my good sir? You look like Mephistopheles himself. Oh, yeah. Baron of Hell. Just die. I think I got the thing now. Oh, hello, Baron of Hell. I do believe you wish me bodily harm. Okay, see, you're like, you're basically a Hell Knight merged with a nymph. Gotcha. Of course, I know what I'm going to do this time. Hello, Baron. I don't think I want you to touch me. Yeah. I'm thinking more and more that I don't want that to happen. Cannon. I need all of this. That's more like it. Shit. Of course, there's another one of you. Oh, there's two. Shit! bad boy. No. I don't want any. I just don't want any. So, no thank you. You gave me some anyway. I gotta save that quad damage. I just gotta save that quad damage. Actually, I'm pretty sure if I had to put an extra Argent cell into my ammo by this point, I'd have enough fuel so that I could kill this. I need to... appreciate all of this. I'd rather not die to you. I don't particularly wish to die to him, but at least it's a more worthy adversary. Motherfuck, fuck it up. King. Fucking the king duck. Oh, fuck me in the asshole. This is gonna be a tough one. I don't think even Mark can do this very well. It's gonna take him a few more tries. He's gonna take a few tries. He's going to be fun to watch. It's not fun to play. It's not very fun to play. It's very fun to have to personally go through this. you, big boy. Guys in a nice big circle. Oh, that's actually, this will actually do me much better. Yeah, there's one.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. I feel like a god after that. So, that was enjoyable when it's enjoyable when play done right. See, the trick to this is it's not enough just to be powerful. I mean, it's not enough to be just to be aggressive. You've actually got to know what you're doing. There is some strategy involved, of all things. You have to be somewhat smart. You have to use your head if you want it to stay on your shoulders, is what I'm basically getting at. Oh, I know about these. So what did that do exactly? This just made it possible for me to go to the last secret, I believe. I believe that's how it works. Oh, here it is. Secret found. Classic map, Doom, Slough of Despair. Yes, every map has one of these secrets that will just unlock. It'll unlock a classic map from Doom. And holy hell. It is very hard to believe that this was not actually 3D. Because that's something that Markiplier mentioned. The original Doom wasn't actually 3D. I'm gonna get lost trying to get out of here. Yeah, it was actually 2D, but it was done in such a way that it appeared 3D. And the reason they did that was not everyone was able to get a computer that could actually handle 3D graphics. But still, the fact that they did that was amazing. And I've got all the secrets! I should get all the prayer tokens now. It's gonna be somewhere up there. Taking my time, as always. Always here. Hello. Goodbye. I'll take that. Oh god, these things only come at me one at a time. That'd be a pain if they didn't. Let's go. Yeah, I don't mind missing out on that. Yeah, you die now. You die quite horribly now. No! After all that, I die. After everything I just went through, I die from that. I die from falling. How much minigun? How much minigun ammo do I got? Just, I'm not. Not entirely sure what the proper term for it is, because it's not just machine. I'll just say machine gun ammo, because it's the same ammo used for. For my assault rifle, basically. Armor did not survive that like it did before. Well, you're still alive, but I don't know where you are. There you are. Okay. So default to shotgun. Did I say default to shotgun? I meant default to Gauss cannon. That's lovely. Double suicide, double kill. I kill you, you kill me. Double KO. Okay, so kill those things. Kill the Mancubus and the two Revenants with something else. Basically. Beautiful. Yeah, don't go down there. That is a bad way to go. Thank you. Uh-huh. That's what I thought. You nothing. You ain't nothing. With this now? Apparently not. I still don't have enough available fuel cells to do that. There's you. Better have gotten that other one. Very skimpy amount of health. That leads to nowhere or nothing. At the same time. Let's find out more about the Doom guy.
And in his conquest against the blackened souls of the doomed, his prowess was shown. In his crusade, the Seraphim bestowed upon him terrible power and speed. And with his might, he crushed the obsidian pillars of the blood temples. He set forth without pity upon the of the Nine Circles, unbreakable, incorruptible, unyielding, the Doom Slayer sought to end the dominion of the Dark Realm.
Okay, so Doom Guy was... I'm probably not... What I'm about to say is probably something that everyone who's ever played Doom before knows, but basically Doom Guy went on a crusade to just completely wipe out everything in hell once and for all. And apparently he was being helped by a Sarah. That's kind of awesome. Give me this. Now I got another prey token and a weapon point. Okay, so that's all of that. This map is actually completely done now. Literally, the only thing left for me to do is just... About the only thing left I can do is get this, max out my combat rating. Oh, this is arming me up for something. Debbie Pierce. I can't remember. Hayden. She's Hayden's protege. Just with the cute idiopathic scoliosis. Shooting is unknown. Permanently wheelchair bound or undergoing teach procedures with the surgery. Repaired on her feet with new titanium exoskeleton grafted into her spinal column. Exoskeleton lets it stand and move on her own. It causes her excruciating pain. So any pain management medication for fear it will cloud her mind. Oh, Jesus. Why not go though? Okay. Personally, I would, in that situation, I'd rather just go the whole 9 yards and become full robot. Why is everything red? And bloody. And awesome. I'm saving that. There might be a Baron of Hell. Thank you. Bit too hectic for my taste. Yeah, I timed that about as perfectly as I could. Y'all remember Doom Guy, right? He's the guy that just murdered all of you once upon a time. Of course y'all remember Doom Guy. That's why you're trying so hard to kill him! Oh shit! The time has come! The time has come! Shit. Yes, Hell Baron. Barons of Hell. I knew those were going to be there. I knew those were going to be there, that's why I saved that. So what is this about Doom Guy being given power by a seraph? My god. That is beyond epic. That makes it more badass than you could possibly realize. Unless you know your angels. Because quite frankly, I'd rather deal with demons than have to deal with an angel, or even just someone blessed by an angel. If an angel decides it's time to go, if an angel decides to ruin your day, you pissed someone off. Royal. Oh shit. Thank you, bitch, from behind. Okay. I'm ready. Die. That'll put me out of reach of most enemies unless they've got range. Oh. Yeah, but as I was saying before, if at any point... I'm trying to talk here. If at any point a seraph decides, just an angel that comes after you, you're screwed. A demon will ruin your day just because it's Tuesday. An angel, you've pissed someone off, and you're going to die. You're going to die horribly. That's why angels are so awesome. Yeah, I'll tangle with demons. Don't tell me there's an angel nearby. Yeah. I'll just kill you and take your health right now. Apparently viciously exploding them counts as a glory kill because I always seem to get health from them. Is that the green of a Hell Knight I see? Oh, yes it is. I believe I should run like hell. That was fun. Okay, so this is the kind of thing I should be doing more often when I'm doing these let's plays. Just talk, flap my gums about anything and... why can't this move faster? Okay, I know what that is, and I know why that's not shaded in. That's the secret room. And I technically didn't go back to it. Here it is. This is where they found him. Oh, big portal. All right. I did everything. I did all the things. I think I redeemed myself a bit. This artificer, you fought your way out of hell and managed to return, but now the demons have staked their claim on Mars. So it's fine. We shut down the hell portal Olivia created. Just another day in the life of Doom Guy. All right. So yeah, it makes sense that they would be guarding the tomb so fiercely. They somehow Like, I don't know if it was explained in any of the other two games, but somehow they managed to get him sealed away and put to sleep. And they didn't want him waking back up. Hell on Mars. Well, it's a bit better than Hell on Earth. It's not Earth.
The Argent Tower is destroyed. The portal can no longer be closed from this side. The Hell energy flows from a location in their world we call the Well. But you've returned. The only flesh and blood to walk between dimensions. So there may be a way. Vega is trying to access Olivia's files. If you can get to the nearest terminal, we will provide you with information. That's all for now.
Okay. Baron of Hell. Okay. Baron of Hell is the highest demon among the Order of Hell Knights. They rarely leave Hell, and no Baron of Hell has yet been captured by any of the tethering operations. Details regarding their behavior and physiology are therefore limited. It's clear that Barons are ferocious fighters with a bloodlust unparalleled by any other demon. And Barons larger and faster than their lesser brothers also possess the ability to generate hell energy fireballs, which can be hurled at a target. In the doomed Project Lazarus manned expedition, it is believed that most of the explorers were set upon by Barons of Hell, though the details were unclear. Tablets retrieved from the Great Steep of the Inesis, the Barons of Hell are the current royal guard of the unknown Dark Lord of the Fourth Age. While the nature of this entity is unknown, it must be presumed that as the Royal Guard's power has significantly increased, so too has the power of their master. I didn't get the extra codex on Summoner. The Summoner, cunning adversary, is primarily a defensive summoning unit. As the demon horde swarms the enemy, the Summoner sustains the battle by opening a rift to Hell and calling forth reinforcements. To prevent being overrun by the relentless horde, the Summoner should be a primary target in a battle strategy. When directly challenged in combat, the Summoner is capable of channeling Hell energy into an Argent wave. Although this wave kills most humans, an occasional victim will be transformed into the Possessed. Surviving an Argent wave attack is extremely unlikely, but does not appear to be random. There is evidence that the Summoner selects the most resilient of combatants for induction to the Army of Hell. Okay, Cacodemons are monstrous psionic demons. Driven by the desire to feed, they display limited intelligence but are often sent into the fray as their natural size and abilities make them an intimidating weapon for the demon horde. I don't even have an additional thing on Hell Knights. The Hell Knight is a towering brute bred for the combat deep in the bowel. Bred for combat deep in the bowels of Hell. These diabolical beasts are the prized gladiators of the demon horde. They relentlessly stomp towards their target, smashing their massive fists into the ground to create shockwaves that stagger their opponent and leave them vulnerable to bone-crushing melee attacks. The Hell Knight's powerful legs allow to leap across large distances effortlessly, quickly closing the gap to its enemy. Okay. These ferocious and agile demons are found all over Hell and are often used in the front line in a concerted attack in either dimension. They revel in battle, feeding off their victims when the hunger takes them. Despite their low status among the demon ranks and their seemingly endless numbers, imps have unique characteristics in battle. Some prefer fighting from an elevated position, while others will rush the target and swipe at them with razor sharp claws. Walls and obstacles offer no defense against imps as they will leap great heights and easily hang from the surfaces. The imp is capable of channeling hell energy through its hands and shaping it into a projectile. As the imp channels the energy, airborne particles and debris are sucked into the maelstrom to create a condensed superheated fireball. The mechanics of the imp's ranged attack suggest that they are actually a lower form of the summoner. I can kind of see it. Lost Soul. These demons are found wandering aimlessly within the temples of Hell as they search for a host and habit. When a potential victim is found, they will converge on the target and explode with a blast of hell energy. Lesser willed beings weakened by the explosion will then be possessed by the demon and the host's soul becomes lost in turn. Tablets retrieved from the Korax suggest that lost souls are considered the lowest of the demons, even lower than imps. Since the wandering nomads, doomed to forever roam the halls of hell, thrive on the weakest entities, lost souls are despised by the other demons. Despite their low status, they should not be underestimated. Mancubus, the Macbeth is a lumbering behemoth demon. A foul odor accompanies its presence, a stench that can be overpowering if inhaled directly. Mancubi gorge on anything they can find and are not averse to eating rancid flesh. Their diet rots in their digestive system, making their innards highly flammable. These foul creatures are decked in light armor when they reach maturity, but their grotesque frame soon outgrows the armor, exposing their stomach and face. I can see that. Mancubi have taken their disgusting physical condition and turned it into a weapon. As they reach maturity, a chitinous growth begins to form over each hand, creating a hard-shelled barrel. As the flesh inside decomposes, a noxious effluvium begins to leak from the barrel. The Mancubus can spew this discharge from the barrel over a remarkable distance. The volatile ghoul ignites under the tremendous pressure, creating a highly effective biochemical flamethrower. Okay, revenants are USC military operators that have been methodically transformed into demonic combatants through cybernetic augmentation and repeated Lazarus wave exposure. The transformation begins by attaching a multiple launch rocket battery onto each shoulder of the patient, coupled to an argent charged neural biochip implanted at the base of the cerebral cortex. The MLRB allows the revenant to both attack its target with multiple conventional rockets and also fire mobility boosters located under each MLRB. Possessed soldier. While Lazarus wave exposure does effectively wipe any vestige of human behavior from most of its victims, some subjects continue to display tactical cognizance posthumously. As with possessed engineers, this does not appear to be random. If an individual has training in combat as part of the UAC military, the Lazarus wave event will transform them into more than mere slaves. This not only further supports the theory that there's some form of genetic coding embedded within the Lazarus wave particles, which governs the outcome of the Lazarus wave exposure on a per case basis. The possessed are created in a Lazarus wave event, a phenomenon first discovered by Olivia Pierce during her Lazarus project. While most victims exposed to argent biowaves, I'm wasting a lot of time, will expire without further effect, some subjects will absorb traces of argent energy and enter a state of posthumous vigor. Despite necrosis of the eternal organs, with the exception of the brain, the victim continues to animate and exhibit a low order of sentience for weeks or even months after clinical death. Posthumous brain activity in the possessed is limited to instinctive behavior. The possessed are known to be territorial when confronted by the living. When isolated, they will enter a dormant state for extended periods of time. They will stand unmoving for days or weeks at a time until presented with a live food source or threatened by a predator. An interesting behavior has been seen when the possessed are held in small groups. They will drag human corpses to a central location within their holding pens and then perform a silent ritual around the pile of bodies. The resulting ceremonial site appears to be the initial stage of a gore nest. These actions must be driven by a telepathic communication with higher ranking demons, as there is no local brain activity that could manage such choices. The possessed will perform these tasks even when the limbs are removed or Pavlovian pain responses are implanted in their cortex, further cementing the theory that they are unwilling slaves performing an integral part of the life cycle of the demons. The possessed create the birthing ground for new demons, and upon expiration are themselves used as fertilizer for the gore nest. During Lazarus wave event, victims undergo dramatic changes to their physiology, both internally and externally. Aside from fundamentally changing the composition of their internal organs, the high-intensity plasma wave is strong enough to fuse metal to skin. In many cases, personal items such as watches and jewelry can burn through the skin and become permanently embedded in the victim. Perhaps the most unfortunate victims of this fusing event are any subjects that happen to be working with acetylene tanks or welding equipment. This equipment is often attached to the body to allow for mobile work in low gravity environments, the Lazarus wave will create a demonized human with a highly combustible explosive device embedded in his skin. As with all possessed creatures, they are mindless and driven through some form of telepathic communication from an unknown demon's overseer. Additional care must be taken when confronting a possessed engineer. If the fuel tank is punctured and doesn't explode, the weakened container can turn the possessed engineer into an explosive projectile. This is a danger to any being nearby, both human and demon. The unwilling are fully transformed possessed that have been transported to hell to serve as shrine worshippers, slave labor for higher level demons, or cannon fodder for battle within hell. Okay. Hellraiser. The Hellraiser is an astute and tactical foe that will engage enemies from long distance with a powerful beam of unrefined hell energy. The beam emanates from an arm-like protrusion composed of cartilage and other osseous tissue. Articulation of the cartilage allows the Hellraiser to focus its energy beam into a single charge shot that will obliterate anything that stands in its path. Possessed Security. Possessed Security units exhibit the most complex battle strategies of all possessed humans, including mobile shield advances towards the enemy and firing while all in defilade. Possessed Security will also drop their shields to adopt a more accurate firing stance at the cost of lowering their defense, which is my chance to blow them the hell up. Okay. So, a few more minutes worth of killing can be done here. So let's see. I wasted a lot of time reading for some reason. Okay, skeet charge. Kill a revenant while it's in midair. Kill 5 demons with the chainsaw. Acquire 3 data logs. Okay, I can do that. I can do all that. Your pardon. Get out of here. This is gonna be a roundabout way, I bet you. It's a little bit hard to see. I could open that. Apparently not. Somebody's home. Yay. Oh, Aki Bento has arrived. That's not Deadpool. That's an elite guard. And, it's Tuesday, so I'm going to cut it here. It's early, but I want to open this video box. So for now, thank you guys so much for watching. As always, I will see you in the next episode. Later.